So here you can find we have the one part with respect to that. This particular blend we need to create. Okay, so blend multi section, what are we going to be have? And here you can check with respect to only changing the point. Okay, so here you can find only changing the point may change the surface, because the whole part will be get updated. So we will check how we're going to be use kind of this method, like parametric modeling. Okay, so for time being, what we're going to be have, we can create something like this as a surface. Okay, so in this condition, you can check in a verb, we have this two particular point. We need to create a point over here. Okay, on edge, we're going to be create a point on this side, 10 mm. On that point, we need to create the plane normal to the line passing through the point. With respect to that, we need to have the intersection. Here you can find, we can create an intersection. And now we can go for the split this. Okay, so we can split this surface. Similar way, we're going to be here over here. We need to have point first on this particular surface with respect to the value we can add. Then we're going to be have the plane normal to the line passing through the point. Then you can have the intersection to this. Then you can split this particular surface over here. And this is how we're going to be have this particular blend command. Okay, here. So what we're going to be do, we can add the boundary over here with the spline. Okay, so we'll add the boundary from the spline. Now that the side as well, we're going to be create the spline. Okay, and we'll check the difference between the blends. You can select the blend over here. Arrow should be on same side. So this is a blend. We can just have the color for the blend. I can hide the blend, and now we can do the multi-section. So this is how we're going to be create the multi-section. Check preview, then going to be add over here. Then again, need to add over here. So something like this we can create, and this particular multi-section to blend, you can check what exactly the difference we have, okay? So this is something like the difference we're going to be have for the blend and the multi-section. Okay, so these are the things is important when we're going to be work with the blend and the multi-section. So whenever there is in a plastic condition, you need to create the surface with the surrounding. So that has to be controlled with the boundary's edge. Okay, it's always recommended to go for the multi-section rather than the blend. You can find what exactly the deviation difference we're going to be have. Okay, so we have the control on this particular edge with the with this particular boundaries of the edge. Okay, so now here you can check, you can change this tangency. Okay, so this particular tangency, you can change this tangency values, and with respect to that, you can find whatever, if you want to have the control over here, so you can change the tangency value. And with respect to that, you can move this, you can just look over here. This curve will be get moved with respect to changing the tangency value. Okay, so this is how you can change the tangency value. And with respect to that, you can have the control on either on this side as well as on this side. Okay, so with respect to that, is always recommended to go for changing this particular value. If you just check over here, if we just change the tangency, okay, here you can find we're going to be change the tangency value. Okay, so we'll have the control on that particular surface. Okay, here you can find, so we're having a control on that particular, so this tangency we are changing in this area. Okay, so this is how we can change, and we can control the surface if required. So this is the most important thing, difference between the blend and the multi-section. Okay, so always recommended in automotive plastic to go for the multi-section rather than the blend, because blend will not have the control on the edges, and multi-section we're going to be have the control onto the edges. For that reason, we're going to be always use multi-section. Now you need to join this multi-section. Here you can find, you can join this multi-section with respect to that. If you want to change this points, okay, so this point, if you just check, so this is something like the parametric surface we have created with respect to changing the any value. Here you can find, with respect to changing any value, you can change this particular surface. Okay, and the same surface we're going to be use, same surface we're going to be use over here into the part. Okay, here we are using into the part, and with respect to that, you can check, this is something like we have the 2 points, and the part will be something like here. We're going to be have to this part. Now we need to change the surfaces. Okay, so you can find we need to change the surface. So here we have 50. So here also we can create the 50. with the 50, we're going to be change the surface. Okay. And now this surface, we're going to be linked to the another surface. This surface, we need to link to the another surface. Why? Because whatever the surface we have in another part, in that we need to keep the constant gap. Okay. So we need to keep somewhere here with respect to 5 mm gap. Okay. For that reason, we need to have always reference. Suppose some person is working on this particular part and he changed the point again over here. So with respect to the shape of the part will be changed. And again, we need to keep the gap. So that gap also need to be changed with respect to the change in surface. So this is why we need to keep the link with these two part. How we can keep the link? So we're going to be use this particular surface. Okay. So this surface we're going to be used and for the publication. Okay. So here you can find what are the surface we have, this bottom surface. We're going to be used to publication. You can check over here into the tools. We have the option publication. You can select the publication. You can add that. And once you click on publication, you can find this joint will be get added over here. Okay. We need to copy. Then you can put over here into the another part. Click onto the part. Check for the space special width link. And you can have this particular surface. Okay. So you can use this surface with respect to add offset to the part. Okay, so here we're going to be add the 5 mm offset. So this is nothing but the original surface we have. Okay, and we're going to be use this as offset now. So whenever you can check, whenever we're going to be change anything over here in this particular point, okay, I can just create now again the 10. Okay, here also again 10. So with respect to this change, you can find the another part is also going to be changed. Okay, so this is something you can find it going to be changed. Okay, so this is how whenever you want to keep any two part link. Okay, so now this surface is linked with the another part. So you're going to be used, what you're going to be used, you're going to be used the parameter publications. Okay, so here you can find you're going to be used the publication. From the publication, what you can do, you can link two parts with respect to any surface, with respect to any point, any line. So you can create over here, you can do that publication, you can create over there, you can do the publication over there. Okay, so this is all about the publication. Whenever you want to link the two part component, in that case we're going to be use this publication, and once we open that two part in the same cut here, we can update that automatically.